Today is a new season for men's soccer as we turn our focus to the Sun Belt Tournament, which we're extremely excited about. Got to start off with Coach Ginepro. Congrats on two great wins. Coach Drink and his staff and his players, a big win down in Columbia. So it's a great day and a great week to be a Mountaineer. For us, it's just about refocusing, you know, trying to concentrate on Howard, who's our first opponent, Wednesday night. It's tournament format, so, you know, win in advance, survive in advance, if that's what it needs to be. But we should have some confidence as, you know, we played Howard in the regular season and we're able to get a win. They've beaten some teams we have not, and we've beaten some teams that they have not. So we're just trying to concentrate on all the positive things and really get our guys focused and prepared to take it one game at a time. We're at home, so we're excited about that. Continuing to build on some of the success we've had this year.
And Coach, this team has 10 wins on the year, which matches the highest win total since 2015. You know, what have you seen on both sides of the ball that makes this team successful?
Yeah, I think they've got a good chemistry. They truly care about each other. They work for each other. You know, they put in the work, you know, so they work extremely hard. They have really since January for these days and these moments that we're about to have. They're great kids, you know, they want to do well. They're ambitious. So I'm real pleased that we've been able to achieve that. But, you know, it's 10 plus was the goal and we're not there yet.
And you have 7 shutouts on the season. Just talk about the defensive effort and then from your redshirt freshman goalkeeper, Jacob Matta, what you've seen from him this season.
Yeah, 7 shutouts is great. We're one shy of what we set for a goal. And, you know, having a redshirt freshman goalkeeper, I think we were ambitious. We trusted him. We knew he worked hard. He went out this summer and played competitively all summer and got some great matches. So we knew he was going to be prepared. We had a more experienced line in front of him. It's like the exact opposite of last year where we had a fifth-year senior in goal and started, you know, 3 sophomores and a freshman. But now they become juniors and sophomores. And Jacob's done a fantastic job. You know, I think it was opening weekend. We played St. John's, who's top 5 in the country right now, and Loyola, who's going to win their conference again. And he made some spectacular saves all preseason. We're telling him, just do the routine, you do you, you know, just make the simple saves. And then he's picked out some spectacular saves and really performed like a sophomore or junior with, you know, 25 games under his belt. So from that point on, it was just like, okay, yeah, just do your thing. And he's been great. You know, we're going to need him this week for sure. So, but can't be more happy for him.
You've got Howard Wednesday at 7 p.m. at Ted Mack. You know, what's the preparation look like for the team this week?
Yeah, kind of like I said in the opening statement, just kind of refreshing. It's a new season, right? We greeted everybody this morning with happy postseason. You know, we have 2 boys from Kenya, and I said, do you know what that means? They said, no. I said, well, it's like Christmas, Hanukkah, your birthday, all rolled into one, because there's no better time than postseason. It's what we all work for. And so we need to enjoy it. But I think, you know, Howard is, again, like I said, they've gotten some results that we haven't. We were fortunate to already have played them this year and had a good result. But the result was the byproduct of our work, our defending first, letting our defenses initiate everything else, and just, you know, really playing a relentless mentality for 90 minutes. So that's going to be the focus this week as well, preparing for them. And that's really all we're thinking about.